This is Laura GB, and in this video, we're going to look at connecting Azure Key Vault to Power Automate. So here we are in my Key Vault that I've set up in Azure. It's called LGB Secrets, and as you can see, we have three secrets, and I'm using these to store passwords. So let's switch over to Power Automate. So here I am in Power Automate. I'm going to go to create a flow and just a quick demo to show how to do this. I'm going to create a instant cloud flow. I'm going to call it finance process, and I'm going to manually trigger it. So we're going to click create. And then I'm going to bring in a new step. And if you search for key, there you are, we get the Azure Key Vault. And it has a whole bunch of actions, but the one I want is get secret. And yes, it's a premium connector. And this is the first time I've done it in this environment, and it appears to sort itself out, okay? But when I go and look at the name of secrets, couldn't retrieve the values. Okay, so it's got a failure. And if I go and have a look on the three dots and my connections, you'll see I've got an invalid connection. So let's go and see what that's about. And we do that by going back to data on the left-hand side here and to connections. And yeah, it's going to complain that I haven't saved the flow, but that's okay. We're just going to rebuild it again in a second. So all of my connections have loaded. I can see at the top there, we've got our Azure Key Vault, and look, it says status parameter value missing. So if I click on the three dots or the ellipses and I pick edit, you can see that it wants the vault name, okay? And that is LGB Secrets. And let's click save. Not sign in. Let's fix the connection. And up pops a login window, which is in my, which is on one of my other screens at the moment. And there we are. It sorted itself. It's connected, and it's happy here. Before we go back and create ourselves a new flow, what I'm going to do is I am just going to do a hard reboot. Control R or Control F5, both will work. And let's just make sure that our connections are listed as we expect and as we want. So there we are, it's connected and it looks fine to me. So I'm then going to go to create, instant cloud flow, finance, manually trigger a flow and click create. Then I'm going to click new step. I'm going to type in key. Click on Azure Key Vault. Get secret. And if I look under the connections now, it's happy. It's fine. If it doesn't appear happy, do a refresh and then try rebuilding your flow. And then here we are. We've got our secrets. So I'm going to click the finance password. And I'm then going to click save. Now, when you save a flow, one of the bits of advice you get is your flow is ready to go. We recommend you test it. So let's go test it and make sure that actually it's working. So I'm going to click manually. I'm going to click the test button. Then I'm going to click continue. And then I'm going to click run flow. And then I'm going to click done. And there we are. Two green ticks, brilliant. But if we look at the get secret thing, we can actually see here is the output. So I can see the password, which perhaps you don't want to do. So last thing to do is to secure the output. So I'm going to click edit, and on this get secret step, I'm going to click on the three dots, and then I am going to go to settings, and I am going to secure the output. Turn that on, and then I'm going to click done. And now we get a little padlock on it to show, if you hover over that, you can see it has secure inputs or outputs. It doesn't matter, doesn't know which, but it knows one of them. So now when I go and test, save and test, run the flow, and click done. There's my run again, and my get secret, when I click on it, you'll see content not shown due to security configuration. And anywhere you use that same value later on in the flow, you'll get the same thing. In this flow, we looked at connecting to getting a secret from our Azure Key Vault and how to fix the connection. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please press subscribe. Take care now.